Gasoline is one of the most flammable substances on Earth, capable of igniting instantly even from a single spark. Whether caused by machinery, electrical faults, or even a lightning strike, this highly volatile cargo can unleash massive destruction if mishandled. Yet, oil tankers transport millions of gallons of this hazardous fuel across the world's oceans every day. Even it's possible to fire an assault rifle on a gasoline tanker, and it would be highly unlikely to cause an immediate explosion. Although doing it is an extremely dangerous and reckless action, but ever wonder how is this possible? How do these colossal vessels navigate such risks, and why the incident rates are too low? In today's video, we'll uncover the science behind these floating fuel giants, and we'll learn how technology, precision, and human expertise work together to protect these tankers. So keep watching our channel, The Curious Corner. Gasoline is widely transported due to its essential role in powering vehicles and fueling industries. However, crude oil tankers typically do not carry gasoline, as it is a refined product with higher volatility and stricter handling requirements. For the transportation of gasoline, tanker trucks, rail cars, and pipelines are used within a country. But for international transport, a specialized type of oil tanker known as a product tanker is used. Unlike the crude oil tankers, product tankers are much smaller and designed to carry refined petroleum products like gasoline, diesel, and jet fuel, which are more volatile in nature and are not safe to transport in large quantities over long distances. Refineries near the destination points typically process crude oil into gasoline and other products, reducing the need to transport these refined products over long distances. As product tankers are vulnerable to storms and rough seas during long journeys, not only the risk of oil spills or vapor emissions are a problem, but certain regions like the Gulf of Guinea and ports of Southeast Asia pose security risks for tanker voyages. In most cases, pirates typically seek to seize the vessel and hold the crew or cargo for ransom. But that's another scenario. The real danger in gasoline transport is not the liquid itself, but the vapors. For an explosion to occur, there must be a flammable vapor mixture with air or oxygen for a reaction and an ignition source. For that, product tankers carrying gasoline are equipped with inert gas systems. Inert gases are those type of gases which are non-flammable and non-reactive. They are also known as protective gases. These gases are pumped into the empty spaces of cargo tanks to reduce oxygen levels. By maintaining the oxygen concentration below 8%, even if flammable vapors are present, combustion cannot occur. These systems ensure to minimize vapor buildup by keeping the oxygen levels low and by maintaining a liquid sealed environment. Even if you fire a rifle directly at the tank, while these systems are intact, an explosion will not occur, as without enough oxygen, an explosion is almost impossible. But if safety systems fail, a bullet could puncture a tank containing a volatile vapor and air mix, and just a little bit of a spark could trigger a catastrophic explosion. Therefore, firearms and other ignition sources are strictly prohibited on tankers. To safely transport gasoline, sparks are the number one enemy. Therefore, all electrical tools and machinery are specially designed so they don't create sparks. While pipes and equipment are grounded, so no static sparks are generated during loading or unloading gasoline. Special valves safely release pressure in the tanks, preventing dangerous gas buildup. Instead of opening tanks and letting gasoline vapors escape into the air, tankers use systems that trap and process the vapors. Sometimes they use water or special chemicals to clean the tanks without creating dangerous fumes. Manual mopping can also generate static electricity, which might ignite residual fumes. Therefore, automated machines with high-pressure nozzles are used to spray water or other cleaning chemicals inside the tank. In the meantime, crew members are strictly not allowed to enter the tanks unless it's necessary. And when they do, they wear personal protective equipment, as direct exposure to gasoline fumes is hazardous to human health. If the ship carries crude oil later, it can use the oil itself to wash away gasoline residues. This method also doesn't create vapors. But these are all the inner workings of a tanker. The tanker's walls and structures are made up of thick steel to withstand harsh ocean conditions, making it unlikely for a bullet to penetrate deeply. And even if the bullet hits the metal, an spark is unlikely. If a small fire were to start, the tanker has firefighting systems like foam and carbon dioxide that can extinguish flames quickly before they spread. Without severe negligence or extreme conditions, it's highly unlikely for an explosion to occur in modern day, unless the staff is not well trained. Because in most cases, it's not just technology and rules, it's the human factor. And for that, the engineers, safety officers, and seafarers work tirelessly to prevent the unthinkable. From preserving the fuel to ensuring its safe transport, their dedication serves as the silent guardians of safety. They are the ones keeping these floating giants secure and efficient, day in and day out. So the next time you see an oil tanker, think about the careful mix of science, skill, and hard work that kept it running safely. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe our channel, The Curious Corner, for more fascinating content.